Washington State University researchers have used the ancient Japanese art of paper folding to possibly solve a key challenge for outer space travel: how to store and move fuel to rocket engines. The researchers have developed an origami-inspired folded plastic fuel bladder that doesn't crack at super cool temperatures and could someday be used to store and pump fuel. The researchers have published their work in the journal Cryogenics. The challenge of fuels management has been an important limiting factor in space travel, largely restricting space travel to either shorter trips for large amounts of cargo or to small satellites for long-duration missions. In the early days of the US space program in the 1960s and 1970s, researchers tried to develop round balloons to store and pump liquid hydrogen fuel. They failed. Every bladder would shatter or leak as they tried to squeeze it at the record very cold temperatures for the liquid fuels. The hottest designs only lasted 5 cycles. The researchers abandoned the effort and instead came to rely on less ideal propellant management devices. Current systems use metal plates and the principle of surface tension to manage liquid fuels, but the systems are slow and can only dribble out fuels in small quantities, so the size of fuel tanks and missions are limited. Through a literature search, the research team came upon a paper in which researchers developed some origami-based bellows. Researchers started studying origami in the 1980s and 1990s with the idea of making use of its complex shapes and interesting mechanical behavior. The origami folds spread out stresses on the material, making it less likely to tear. The researchers decided to apply the origami design to develop a fuel bladder using a thin mylar plastic sheet. Having never tried origami before, it took a couple tries and a few hours with a YouTube video to figure out how to fold the bellows. Once folded it, the team tested it in liquid nitrogen at about 77 degrees Kelvin. The researchers found that the bladder can be squeezed at least 100 times without breaking or leaking under cold conditions. They have since demonstrated the bellows numerous times, and it still doesn't have holes in it. The researchers are now beginning to conduct more rigorous testing. They plan to do testing with liquid hydrogen, assessing how well they can store and expel fuels, and comparing the flow rates of their bladder with current systems.